afternoon and welcome to Fairview Park. I'm going to fly this crazy contraption. This is the new Flite Test Goblin designed by Andrus, and I've modified it just a little bit. It's supposed to be powered by a single pusher prop right there in the middle, like maybe on a 2205, 2306 on a 3 or 4 cell. You can see that I don't have that. That's not what I have. So, a guy named Jim, I believe, gave me a couple of these little 56mm EDFs and said, do something crazy with it. So, when the Goblin came out, I thought, well, that's perfect. So, I need to put a battery in it, and the nose has to get longer, and I can't do that with one hand, so I'll be back to you in just a minute. Plug this monster in.
Wow, a lot of control surface.
Yeah, well, that's why we have multi-rates.
Whoa.
We'll probably start on mids, just because you never know.
You might need it to.
Yeah. All right, now, hopefully we don't see any magic smoke.
Oh, you haven't even powered it up yet?
No, I've powered it up, just okay. Not on this battery.
Wow.
I mean, these are 4,800 kV motors, and I think they're probably supposed to be run on 3-cell.
48, and that's a 4S?
Yeah. So, it's gonna make some
those
noise.
Those are probably 2S.
There you go. Don't feel anything shaking around.
Nothing.
That's a good sign. And we're right on the dots. That feels good. As they say, here goes something. I am fully prepared for these motors to just completely smoke themselves before I even leave my hand. That's just the spinner. I don't need a spinner.
What is that? The prop cones.
I'll just take the other one off. Oh boy.
Yeah, that sounds nice.
Okay. So we're at half throttle.
Oh my god, faster. Oh yeah. Faster or it blows up, one or the other.
That's gonna be the trick.
Here it goes. Sounds like a UFO, it's cool.
Looks kinda like a UFO.
Bring it up into the high throttle range.
Oh, we're landing now.
Uh-oh, what happened?
Probably a thermal cutout. Heads up. Woo! Hey.
Have you done the math to see it, how fast they're spinning?
No, that's math I'm scared to do.
Oh, come on.
Okay, wait, can we smell?
Yes.
Oh, there's smoke coming out of here, this one.
I smell something.
This motor is smoking.
Yeah, I smell something.
And that tail cone is warm. And the tail cone's not actually touching anything.
Are those metal or plastic?
Oh, they're plastic. So that was the crazy jet goblin, bat goblin, I don't know. Pretty sure that's the only flight that this one's going to see, because one of the motors was smoking out of the tail cone, and it's not supposed to do that. And the tail cones themselves right here were still are quite warm. I held a little bit of them on with hot glue, and the hot glue is melted. It gives you an idea of the temperatures. The ESCs I can feel in there are not warm, so I'm pretty sure that, and the battery doesn't even care. So yeah, I'm fairly certain that we just cooked the motors. So thanks, Jim, for that awesome flight. I can't wait to see the video. You already saw it because you're watching this video. So yeah, now we'll fly the other things that I brought that are slightly less crazy, but also fun. Okay, so my buddy here, what's your name?
Paul.
Paul did some math for us on the fly here and figured with a 4800 kV motor on 4S charged to, what, 16.4 volts we use?
64 volts.
The no-load RPM was 72,000 RPM. If you figure a 15% loss because there's a fan, you know, pulling load, that's still 61,000 RPM. That is that's 10 faster than the Turbo B motors were spinning, and that was from data. So this is just, yeah.
The fact
that it actually flew that many times around the field before it decided to say I'm cooked is pretty impressive. So we've pushed them to the limit, and we brought it back in one piece, and now I can put a more reasonable motor setup on here. You know me, it's not going to be that reasonable, but slightly less crazy than this, and it'll fly maybe more than once.